serious, what could happen to make 2020 worse? War, pretty much. This can become infinitely worse if some major countries decided to fight each other. Food shortage. A super volcano erupting. Mount St. Helens is due for one. Not sure if that is classified as a super, but still. Geologist here. We are notoriously bad at predicting when, how big volcanic eruptions and earthquakes will be. The saying one is due doesn't mean anything. Events are sometimes periodic, and sometimes not. If you've gone a long time without an event, you might get a big one next. And you might not. The best indicator is a sudden increase in seismicity. But that can also lead to nothing. The self-isolation ban lifts too soon and COVID-19 keeps spreading. Which is gonna happen, laughing face? The Black Plague lockdown lasted for like 10 years I think, and then we're in 4 months with this whole COVID-19 thing, and the governors are opening up beauty parlors again because their wife apparently needs a haircut that badly. This is horrible, but not the Black Plague. The obvious things have been covered, which are large scale, but people often don't comprehend the monsieur, so the things which could make 2020 worse for you. Asterisk death of a loved one. Asterisk loss of home. Asterisk loss of job, with no chance of getting another one. Asterisk the sudden realization that you're going to be 30 and have achieved nothing. Progress nowhere. Have few friends who care and will be spending your birthday effectively alone due to lockdown. My 30th birthday is today. This hits too close. A huge solar storm that knocks out the power grid. We're currently in solar min, so this is unlikely. 2020 is already full up with unlikely. If you don't know, we now have to worry about giant hornets. Things just get more Jumanji-er by the day. Hurricane. I live in Florida. Hurricanes, as in more than one making landfall, would be worse than that. You can expect more this year than usual. The Atlantic is very warm for the time of year. Imagine what would happen if there was an evacuation during a lockdown. I nearly lost my house to bushfires in late December, early January. Now I'm most stuck inside said house thanks to COVID-19. I wouldn't be surprised if there was a fucking flood that suddenly ends the decade-long drought. The region has suffered from monsieur. I have accepted that anything's possible at this stage. COVID-19 mutates and becomes way more deadly. Look on the bright side. If shit hits the fan hard enough, a lot of student loans will suddenly vanish. Alien invasion. At this point, they're probably just waiting for us to wipe ourselves out. Work smarter, not harder, right? Unless they want us as food. Then they'll want to get here before we wipe out their food supply. Duh, we can just build a space wall. Problem solved. We will build a wall and Mars will pay for it? Answer. If one of my very good friends committed suicide. Seriously. I spent the past 12 hours making sure that didn't happen. Take care of your loved ones in every way possible. This little thing called Yellowstone turns out to be slightly worse than expected. Trump could win in November. Think of it this way. It's most likely the worst economic and social consequences of this year's crisis will be at its peak next year. Whoever's president will be blamed for it. If the person who created this shitstorm is left holding the bag, at least they get to experience their well-deserved backlash. That's what I keep telling myself. At least because, like it or not, I think he's probably gonna win. Researchers discover that there's never going to be a vaccine. There isn't. In 1899, everything that could ever be invented had already been invented, according to that one guy. That's not true. We still came up with awesome stuff like the shake weight. When bans get lifted, mass hookups, and then herpes outbreaks. Not to mention, there's going to be a huge increase in Christmas, New Year's babies in a large portion of the world. I'm actually positive we won't see an increase. I feel like people are less likely to have unprotected sex during these times because we aren't really sure when this is going to be over. Well, we haven't had a big asteroid in a while. A large-scale terrorist attack. define large scale. I was thinking like a few thousand people dead and multiple thousand people injured. A dirty bomb. Well, aside from an obvious second wave of COVID that's going to happen. Lost to the power grid or other services like water or sewage. Civil unrest when people realize that this quarantine and epidemic are going to make the rich richer and the poor will get poorer. Alien invasion, or a faked alien invasion. Martial law. Extreme food shortages. Betty White passes away. Alien invasions or huge tornadoes across the globe. Honestly, at this point nothing is too unlikely to happen. Another economic crisis worse than the Great One, and governments falling due to the crisis. Death of electoral democracy in the name of saving lives. Yup. Insert that famous quote about those that would give up essential liberty in exchange for temporary security deserve neither. Those who would choose safety over liberty deserve neither and will lose both. Yellowstone erupting. Look on the bright side. If this happens, most people in the continental U.S. won't have time to lament it. A brighter side is that it's not that likely. If the geologist that wrote a thing about it here on Reddit last year was right. I mean, that caldera isn't really that fragile. It'd take a nuke blowing underneath it to set it off. To me, my best friend dying, he told us before, has severe asthma issues, and something like what's happening right now could potentially kill him. Here in TBH, I try to check up on him every day to make sure he's still with me. 4 more years. A new strain of COVID-19, or another similarly virulent pathogen but with a 90% fatality rate. It would snuff itself out well before it became an epidemic with that death rate. Aliens do happen and they aren't friendly. Based on the progression of plagues. Death of the firstborn. Crap, I'm a firstborn. North Korea launches a successful nuclear missile and hits a city in California. That would be a big loss, but on the other hand, North Korea would stop existing. Natural disasters. If the big earthquake hits California, something called everyone launches their nukes at each other. Total global thermonuclear annihilation. Think. Economic crash. That's already happening. World War III actually happening. The second wave of corona being worse than this one. And those are just the worst ones that could happen. Second and third wave of corona cases and deaths to be worse than the first. 1918 wants its timeline back. Well, murder hornets are here now, so there's that. People not willing to social distance and a resurgence of COVID infections occurring, creating a second, third wave, swamping hospitals. Emp wiping out the electrical grid. Aliens. Everything is possible. Zombies. Hurricane. Cat 3 or higher. In NY, NJ, both states have been hit hard by the pandemic and are already stretched thin. A strong hurricane would be devastating. Massive civil unrest within the US, bringing us to another civil war. Nuclear winter. Second wave of COVID-19 gets more people infected, because they won't follow another governmental shutdown and quarantine. And it gets deadlier. Don't remember the name, but there's some island off the coast of Africa, and once a piece of it breaks off, it would cause a worldwide mega tsunami. Places like NYC would see nearly 100-foot waves. I think it's called the La Palma tsunami. Thank you. That was an interesting and disturbing read in Wiki. A wave that surged up the opposite side of the head of the bay to a height of 1,720 feet. 524 meters. Quote, how long till it breaks off? It's one of those that doesn't have a certain date. Could be today, next week, or in 300 years. Whenever it happens, it happens. That COVID is a biological warfare and that they will continue to make super viruses until we are wiped out. Who are we? I mean, who is the other side making the virus? A Great Depression. This season of Earth is entirely too unrealistic. What have the writers been thinking? Realistically, possibility a terrorist attack. We kinda forgot about what happens at the beginning of this year with the US killing a high-ranking general. They could quite possibly planning an attack against the US. Oh shit, I forgot about that. Japanese giant hornets start carrying COVID-19. Hurricane season is expected to be particularly harsh this year, as well as record-breaking heat waves. But that may be a mostly American problem. Other possibilities include a COVID-19 mutation that makes it more lethal, complete economic collapse, war, political uprisings, drought and famine causing food shortages, and unforeseen natural disasters. Personally, I'm feeling a tsunami, but I like super rabies as a wild card. Write that down. I'm just waiting for people to find out that COVID-19 also makes you infertile. This would fit well into a future similar to The Handmaid's Tale. The self-isolation goes on too long and the economy crashes, burns, and countless starve. I already lost the girl I loved in my job. Anything else that happens now is a blessing as far as I'm concerned. I'm too much of a coward to kill myself, so hopefully whatever comes next actually does. Please don't say that. Godzilla. North and South Korea start fighting each other. Edit. Apparently there was an incident Sunday where there were shots fired in the DMZ. Doesn't appear that things escalated though, thankfully. Apologies. This was a serious response to the question. Thankfully, that's not likely. Neither side has anything to gain from that. SK doesn't want Seoul to get flattened in the initial artillery barrage. NK doesn't want Pyongyang to get flattened in the resulting American airstrikes. It's theoretically possible if someone worse took over and they were even more detached from reality. But the senior leadership knows they can't win a war with the US. They just have bark loudly so everybody leaves them alone. A lot of things. New viruses being unleashed from the ice due to global warming. Another dumbass president. People claiming to be the Messiah and say that they'll bring everyone to safety in their taco ship. Drought. Famine. Water shortages. Cthulhu rising from the fucking sea. And many more. Kim Jong-un is actually dead and someone far worse and more competent takes over and causes the next war. Kim Jong-un was probably one of the most competent leaders that North Korea possibly could have ever got. He was well-educated and most of his moves made sense given North Korea's unique geopolitical situation. A more competent leader than Kim Jong-un would avoid war at all costs. With regimes like North Korea, the aim is to stay alive. They know their bark is a lot worse than their bite. It would actually be a much less competent, more unstable leader that would be an issue and actually have a chance of causing war. Good point. Solid argument. Or a succession crisis. So many things. Just today, the Japanese giant hornet has started to permeate through the country. They hurt like hell, kill wildlife, and kill people. Takes 3 to 4 stings for a peaceful sleep. It can also keep re-stinging you, so good luck, American fellows. The only way I can think of to combat them beyond killing their queen and nests is to import the honeybees who know how to kill them by giving them the hug of death. And then a meteor hit, and they ran as fast as they could from giant cat monsters. And then a giant tornado came. And that's when things got knocked into 12th gear. A Mexican armada shows up with weapons made from tomatoes. Nice try, God. COVID-19 goes through a mutation and starts spreading through air. But it does spread through the air. In the attempt to make a cure for the coronavirus, something goes wrong and a new and deadlier virus appears. Or an alien invasion. Or Lovecraftian horror ends up being real. A crash on something like the internet caused by too much usage at one time. Or running out of a basic necessity like milk for a long time. I could see riots over something like that. The insect apocalypse shit. A really bad natural disaster, especially in developing countries, would cause detrimental effects. Coronal mass ejection takes down the power grid. Betty White, no one can find the cure until 2025. Please don't jinx us all. WW3. North Korea starts a war with South Korea, which would eventually lead to WW3. That's not very likely to end in a world war. China and the US would get involved and Russia might, then Europe might get dragged into it as well. If NK attacked SK, Seoul would get flattened in the initial artillery barrage. But American counter-battery fire would remove NK's artillery within minutes, followed immediately by cruise missile strikes to remove anti-air emplacements, granting us air superiority and the ability to bomb with impunity. After that, it's a question of whether NK sends a nuke somewhere or not. If they throw a nuke and it goes off, Pyongyang will get deleted by American nukes. Afterwards, China steps in, mumbles something about both sides are bad and takes over North Korea. Or we skip the nukes and go straight to China controlling NK. There's pretty much no situation where it goes to WWIII. If you want WWIII, you need direct confrontation between American and Chinese Russian forces. And that just won't happen. America doesn't want to deal with North Korea now when it's only a starving nation of peasants. Let alone after it's a radioactive starving nation of peasants with no leadership. We'll just bomb it until China steps in. China doesn't even want NK either. They just want a buffer from SK. Russia doesn't have a horse in this race. Relations between them and NK soured decades ago. I absolutely see no way how Europe would get involved. NATO doesn't work over there, and as long as there are no European naval assets nearby, chances are very slim that Europe could get involved. Russia being dragged in also seems questionable, but far more likely. Technically, they're still at war because they never signed a treaty from the Korean War. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.